It's a bit frosty out, but as you can tell, the rain stopped, so I think it's okay to go out again.
That doesn't mean I'm not gonna make a walkthrough part, though. I mean, come on now, let's be realistic here.
Hey, look what I found out how to do. Hello everyone, and welcome back to the walkthrough. All I'm doing is just doing a spin on the begin story mode title screen, it's a save file select thing. Anyway, I'm gonna start out the part by going back to the Great Geysers for a Nabbit chase. Let's do this. You know, I wonder if I should grab the power-up right here. Yeah, that would probably be a good idea. Because he always slows down anyway if he gets too far ahead, so it's like, yeah, well, why not? And, getting too reckless. Watch for the cheap-cheeps, PkGam. Cheap-cheeps are the deadliest of fish. Okay, maybe not that deadly. There's boss bass in comparison. Oh, I'm doing terrible at this. Very, very bad. Maybe I shouldn't have gotten that power-up. Well, I'll have another shot at it. So yeah, maybe I shouldn't have gotten that power-up. Oh, and in case you didn't know, I don't have a star, which is why I didn't really bother to go into my item inventory screen before starting this. But okay, it would probably be a bad idea to do any spinny spin flying maneuvers here, because that would definitely slow me down. Oh, cheap jeeps! Oh, dang it! I hit the block. I thought that jump was gonna be good, but I misjudged it. Why must the cheap cheeps be in my way so drastically? I guess I'll use another one. I mean, why not? Alright, Nabbit. I know your route. I know your plan. You're not gonna get away from me this time. I kinda like Luigi's floaty jump for this here, and whoops, I accidentally hit the... hit the flight button. Well, I'm catching up, sort of. I don't like when he, like, jumps forward. He gets a lot of distance quickly when he jumps forward. Holy poopers, he's quick. Catching up. Aha! Right at the end, with 69 seconds remaining. Someone's gonna mention that. Woo! That was pretty tricky. I wish I had a star. Yeah, I think what happened on the other Nabbit chases was that I used a star and it just completely broke the chase in every single way possible. Anyway, let's go over to the mushroom house, well, item house thingy here. And I gotta remember to not grab the Bowser head. Do not grab the Bowser. Just go for the toad first. Aha, there we go. No. Now, which one? I think you had the flower. I'm gonna hope. Yes! Best outcome I was aiming for. Woohoo! Now I've recovered some of the lost powers that I lost. Well, you can't really replace the delightfulness of a propeller mushroom, but that's a pretty good substitute. Alright, let's go to the castle and finish off World 3. Larry's Trigger Happy Castle. Torpedo Ted's Bonsai Bill on the pursuit. Rotational cannons. Danger left and right, all poopers. How do I get out of here? You're probably like, yeah. Boop. Dang it. I'm wasting too much time here. I need the other cannon to fire, if at all possible. Well, maybe I don't. Aha! Luigi's got a really, really good jump. Oh, shoot. Keep ducking. There we go. I noticed that when you are in the ducking animation, when you collect something, you still stay in the ducking animation, which means that you'll be one square high. Oh, these are special Torpedo Teds. What they like to do is when they get near the edge of something, they turn around and home in on you. Come on, break this open, come on, you guys can do it, I have faith that you can do it. Oh, I mean, you're built to explode, for Pete's sake. Oh, I can get in. I just had to try and bait it away from where I was going in, otherwise I would end up trapped. Nope. Oh! Sometimes they don't explode when you want them to. And I have a feeling something's gonna come through that wall. Oh, jeez! Sumo Bill! Run for your life, Luigi! Run! There's probably a secret button next to the door, but I don't care at the moment because I'm gonna die! Well, actually, I could have hidden that little alcove and I would have been fine. That's probably what it was for. I panicked and didn't do it right. Well, that's fine. It's all gonna work out, I hope. I mean, I got all the coins in my first run through this level, so I would really hate to lose that. Let's do this. Bring it on. Okay, what do you have? Oh, you got water spells. Big deal. And you're gonna, I believe it's affected by water spells. Yep, just as I thought. Just avoid it. And just try and feel out the timing of when it's going to pop back out. All the Koopa kids seem to have about the same timing when they pop back out of their shell. And it's just, once you get that timing, it really trivializes the Koopa kid bosses. Then again, I could say that about Boom Boom as well, because defeating Boom Boom with ease is based off of timing when he gets out of stunned shell mode, so to speak. And with that, World 3 is 100%ed. Do a dance, Luigi! Do the Ouija! Eventually. There we go! Woo! Alright, now we can go head on over to World 5. Be warned, as soon as you enter this world, you will immediately start a level without your permission. Oh no! Luigi napped! Soda Jungle Dash Airship, all aboard! And there's Luigi on the back of the ship. Why would they have a Luigi on the back of the ship? I do not know. Anyway, you can jump on these nuts by jumping on them repeatedly. Oh, shoot! You can jump on them repeatedly, and you'll be able to move forward using them. And keep going, Luigi. We go. No boomerang, bro. Need to keep my jumps low to avoid the bro. Okay, we are doing good. I think. Wait a second. Hold on. Okay, I just wanted to see if there's a hidden thingamabob over there. Beware. Sumo brother, oh jeez, why are you there by that coin? Why? Okay, that wasn't that. Oh, that was a second coin? Where the heck is the first one? Oh, there's the third. I remember those two. But I mean, where was the first one? I mean, I clearly missed it. I probably had to, like, ground pound underneath something. I mean, ground pound through something in order to get it. And, oh, I just killed something off-screen there. I guess it was that hammer, brother. Woo! Wait, 150 seconds? This could only mean one thing. A long Bowser Jr. battle! Love his voice. Alright. All you have to do is get the torpedoes to hit him. Touching him won't do anything to you. So keep that in mind. Just try and move in sort of, I guess you could say, sort of random locations, because it's very hard to, oh shoot, that was perfect. Well, it was, except for the collision. But I mean, it's very hard to get him to go where you want him to go and with the torpedo, so just focus on dodging and sort of try to lead them into him, but don't get your hopes up, because he tends to move out of the way of the torpedoes. Oh, dang it! See, just like that. I think that's the reason why they give you so many seconds for this boss, because it's a pretty finicky boss. It's not all that hard. It's just very finicky to get him to do what you want him to do. There we go. One hit out of three. Come on, recover faster. Uh-oh. And watch them collide. You gotta watch their change positions. There we go. Don Maku style Mario. Okay, there's not that many bullets. Okay. Wait for it. Turn around there. Good boy! Yeah! One more hit, and we should be good. Oh, time is tight. Yeah, you always want to be, like, at the center when he's, like, in between hits, so you aren't in the way of the torpedo teds. It's just a way of making sure you have enough time to react to where they're coming from. Hit him! Yes! Yes! But I gotta do it again, because I missed the coin somewhere, dang it. Woo! Uh-oh. What are you taunting for? Oh, I see why. The hand of God is back. Oh! Almost swatted Luigi like a mosquito. And this unlocks up the path over to where the two worlds joined up. Well, after Bowser runs like a coward. Woo! See those, that's the path where all three places meet up, and that also leads to Soda Jungle Dash 1. But we aren't done yet. We are not done yet. We have to get a coin somewhere around here. I bet you it's somewhere. Oh! Yep. It just seemed like it would be there because there was a hammer bro in a very tight area. And I didn't notice that you could move the nuts by rolling something across them. That's interesting. Well, now you know where the coin is. The question is, though, can I hold my own, beat this level, and beat Baby Bowser? Bowser Jr. once again. That reminds me, Bowser Jr. and Baby Bowser are actually two different characters. That was really close. A lot of people confuse the two. Oh, shoot! No! Bad timing on my jump. Yeah, a lot of people confuse the two characters, thinking that they're one and the same. But no, Bowser Jr. is Bowser's son, while Baby Bowser is like Bowser from another time. Hence why it's known as Baby Bowser. You know, it's not Bowser Jr., because Jr. implies that there is another version of a character, so to speak. You know, like a later person in the family line, so to speak. So yeah, just I would give that random clarification for those wondering about that for all these years, I suppose. Just as long as I'm talking about stuff and stuff and stuff. Freeze, yes! Okay. No! Jeez! I don't trust these nuts. Why are these nuts so treacherous? It just seems like their timing is just so weird to jump on them. It was like that on Mario 3 as well. It's like the timing isn't when you touch the nut immediately, it's like a little bit after you touch the nut, if that makes sense. Oh shoot! I was a little too high on my throw there. That's alright. Alright, rematch! Bowser Jr., go! I didn't do it in a high enough pitch of voice. Alright, it's 180 seconds to defeat this dastardly kid. Turn around here, and go down here, see what I- Oh shoot, that was bad on my part. At least it's not all that difficult to avoid taking a hit on this boss. It just thought it was kind of dumb there. Okay. We're good. We're still good. Just calm down. Maybe I should actually stay above him. Because you never know when a torpedo Ted is going to be thrown out from, beneath the clown copter. Well, it's more like a clown submarine in this game. Go down. Oh. You'll notice that when he launches them, they go in a horizontal line at first, but then they start bouncing around the edges, so to speak, in the most, that was close. Yeah, in the most convenient way to aim for you, basically. I don't know if that helps you dodge them, but that's how they react. Alright, go up, good. Oh! Go back around. Go, yes!
Success!
Oh yeah! Oh yeah! Boy, those last couple stages took me a while to complete. I mean, I did a couple of side stuff as well, but...
No!
So yeah, I think what I'm gonna do is end off the part here then, because that... we're very close to like 15 minutes 30 seconds or so, I'm estimating with the random intro, the random IRL intro, I guess you could say. So with that, I'm gonna end it off here. I hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you in the next part!